Hey guys, welcome to Fit Body Bootcamp TV. My name is Turner Cavender. This is Irasema. Today we're going to talk about the proper shoes that you should wear. Hey guys, let's jump right into it. So, proper feet shoe wear is important because with the shoes, the contact you have with the ground goes to your ankles, knees, and then your hips, and then up your back, okay? It all starts from there, so having the proper type of shoes for the exercise that you're doing is very important. There's all types of exercise that you can do, but today we're gonna talk about boot camp and what you should wear in the boot camp exercise format. So I'm gonna hand it over to Irasema. She knows a lot about it, so let's talk about it. Tell us about the shoes.
Well, we're trying to set you up for success, and that begins from the bottom up, so we're gonna talk about shoes. One of the biggest issues that we have here in boot camp is people don't know what a athletic shoe should be, okay? Just because it has a Nike check on it does not mean that you should just do it, okay? Running shoes, do not wear to a boot camp. Running shoes are built to make your foot move one direction and one direction only, forward.
It's like wearing heels almost, like.
Correct.
Yes.
That means that your ankle is restricted from moving side to side, which means that the rest of your leg has to overcompensate for the lack of movement in your foot, okay? If you've ever seen a baby move around, do a squat, you can see that their foot moves weird. That's because they have mobility, but that's because they have free range of motion in their foot. So I'm gonna ask Turner to take off his shoe, and I'm gonna show you what you should be looking for. As you can see here, this shoe has minimal heel. When it comes from the front all the way to the back, it does not have a significant heel. If you look at running shoes, they typically have a very big platform, okay?
Especially in the back because of heel striking, right?
Correct.
So they need to cushion that.
Which, by the way, shoes are built that way to correct heel striking. So if you've ever gone to a shoe store and they've given you a shoe with a high platform, that means that you're running incorrectly, which we can fix here also.
Yep.
Okay. So you want to look for a shoe that has a minimal platform or what we call a heel drop. Okay. You can go through a local Nike store, Adidas, whatever your choice is in footwear, and tell them that you want something with a minimal heel drop. Okay, they'll give you something that looks nice and flat, okay? Might feel weird at first. I do say, as soon as you switch from a platform type shoe into a flat shoe such as this, great job Turner on choosing these, your calves are going to hurt, okay? You're not used to using your calves. That's gonna be the first complaint. If you're a female and you've worn heels for an extensive period of time throughout
the week. Or like all day at work.
Yeah.
Which we have a lot of that.
Switch to flats and you notice that you get a calf cramp, it's because you're not using anything, okay? Like he mentioned at the very beginning, the inability of our ankle to move essentially ends up affecting from the bottom up. It's a ladder domino effect, okay? Mm-hmm. Ends up affecting your knees. So if you have knee pain, what we call jumper's knee or patellar tendonitis, usually comes from weak calves and ankles, then that affects our hips, affects our low back, and affects our posture all around.
So the way, for some of you that, you know, they're just learning this, you're gonna take this information and you're gonna go get the correct shoes, right? Yes, you are, okay? But in the meantime, we want you to correct what you have injured yourself, because you might not feel like you've injured yourself, but you have if you've been coming to boot camp with running shoes especially, okay? So the first thing you should do is to foam roll your calves and your anterior tibialis. That's basically your shin muscles, okay? So foam rolling you can do here in Fit Body Boot Camp before sessions, after sessions, or you can do and buy those at the local store for $15 to $20, okay? Also, another thing I like to do is to have people get a golf ball and roll it on the arch of your foot, okay, and break all the scar tissue up. I guarantee a trick I like to do with my clients is I like to have them bend over and just hang and see how close their hands are to their feet, then I have them roll the arch of their foot and then do that again, and you'd be amazed how close your fingers will get to your toes. Okay, try that little magic trick I have. Guys, this is great. amazing. Thank you so much for explaining to everyone about the proper shoe wear. Guys, take this information and go to the store and get you the correct shoes, because we don't want you being injured. Our goal is to keep you safe, all right? We want you to have results and no injuries and pain-free, okay? Take this information, share this with your friends, okay? If you don't know anybody out there, I guarantee just post it on your Facebook. Somebody's gonna learn something, okay? That is not a bad thing at all. So share it with your friends and family. I know I am gonna do the same thing. Please, everyone, have a good day. Take care.